today, boy. Hey, boy. Stay home today, boy. Hey. Sup, guys. So me and Ben have got a pretty decent fencing job on for the next week. So just doing a bit of a before and after. So got a line that runs down here. It's about 350 metres. Virtually straight, a little bit of rolling country. So yeah, that'll be good. Gateway here, new strainer, then down through here. Made some progress. So banged in our strainer, got our guide up, marked out 4 meter post spacings. Yeah, just started our ramming really. Gauging our post as we go. Benny's already tied on a second wire. Well, about to tie on a second wire. And so yeah, we might as well run a wire out with the tractor. Jenny's on the tractor. Just one extra wire. The bro doesn't have to walk out, eh, G? Yeah. It's a pretty straight line, this one. It's about 400 metres, just shy of 400 metres, I think. This wire here is 315, that's what the farmer wants to use. So, yeah, nice, is going all good. Ramming's fucking cream. Soft as, so we'll peel into it. Got some posts laid out. Yes. So, here we got posts on the front of the tractor. We like to load right up, and the tractor driver, he can just throw a few posts out as we go. And also, we're marking out post spacings with a rod. I'll show you that once we get up there. Right, so here's a different system, guys. We got this, what'd you call this, like pipe? Is it like PVC pipe or something, Ben?
Conduit pipe.
Use it and to run electrical wiring normally.
Yeah, we've got it cut to 4 meters. Works pretty well when you've got nice flat going like this, and you just sort of throw it along. Most people use measuring wheels, or you can use measuring tapes for shorter stuff. Some guys will just step it out, but this works quite well. You see what Ben's up to here. Let's get the perfect 4 meters. When we spray our paint too, we spray it on the inside so the tractor driver can see it. A lot more obvious when it's on the inside. Sometimes it's on the outside, your back wheel and shit covers it, eh, bro?
Yeah, makes it a lot harder to see. Yeah.
Hey, mate. Yeah. We'll be right back.
thanks to Ben's missus, come home after a mean day on the fence line.
Hey guys, right, so I'm heading into the bush for an overnight trip. Just a quick little mission. I've just had my daughter today, which is good. Yeah.
Your fingers. Say hello.
On the farm, feeding out. Shit. Oh well. Pretty much my first time driving this tractor. The old man's new case. Pretty different.
New cows.
New cows.
All right. Feed them the hay. Hey, you've been a good little helper, eh? She's been a good little helper, even though she wants me to carry her back to the tractor, eh? Hey. You can walk the next one we do.
You drive, you steer, you drive. Good deal. Watch where you're going, don't worry about me. Yeah, watch where you're going.
Yeah, it's party mode, let's go. Turn it up. Woo! Watch where you're going, steer the tractor this way. And running, hey. You gotta watch, don't put us into the trees.
Yeah, so right, the plan now is I'm heading into the bush and I'm meeting up with Jacob and Benny, my brother. They're already in there, so just going to head into quite an easy spot, one of the spots where we know quite well. So the aim is to try and get Jacob on the board, get him his first deer. This is actually his first bush trip. The old cuzzy who's famous for flipping the old motorbike.
Car pie.
Yeah, the old KX, eh? The old KX125. See you later. It's all... You guys know what I'm talking about. Anyway, yeah, I'm all packed. And, good to go. It's just going to be a night mission. The time I get up to the car park, should be dark. So, nah, it's all good. We'll go get into it. I was coming up the road and I was just like I don't think I packed my headlight, just went through my pack, no headlight, gone through the ute, no headlight, and I'm doing a night mission, so I'm just going to walk in the dark. There's no moon out or anything, so test the old eyesight out. Been eating plenty of carrots. I've actually bought bugger all on this trip because I'm in and out. Obviously I'm not going to get a bloody afternoon or evening hunt in. The only hunt we'll get in is tomorrow morning, first thing, and then maybe a little bit during the day. So yeah, all I bought in was my sleeping bag, a few clothes, and a couple beers. That's it. Just relying on the boys, that they've got plenty of tucker and possibly more piss. Now, I know you guys can't see anything, but neither can I really. That's us. I don't mind walking in the dark. It's not too bad. You give it a bit of time and your eyes actually start adjusting. They're the boys.
Just told them that yeah. He can just show up spontaneously.
Yeah.
You never know what's going on.
Yeah. No headlight, boys.
No headlight.
Oh, yeah. Not even a headlight.
Nah. I was about to pull my phone out on the crossing.
Yeah.
I thought, I'll be a stubborn cunt.
Yeah, yeah.
The only reason I would have pulled it out is to keep my feet dry.
Yeah, yeah.
Slipped in, wet feet.
Oh.
I got a spare pair of fucking, or dry pair.
Oh, yes, you made it, mate.
You enjoy your walk in?
Oh, mate, loved it.
Yeah.
Scenery,
how's the calves?
Yeah, not too bad.
Yeah. Have we got some company here?
Mm-hmm. Yeah, just got a little family.
Oh, yeah.
Just, a couple in there, some.
Oh, yeah. Shit, they'll be struggling for. There's only five beds here, eh?
No, six.
Is there six?
Yeah. Six.
Oh, I've got a mattress then. I was preparing for like sleeping on the floor tonight.
Yeah.
Chucked another hoodie in just for another layer, just in case it was hard. But yeah.
No, you're sweet, bro. You got yourself a bed.
Fire's blaring.
He's sitting there like he's a king. Eating grand waves.
Happy dog.
Oh, gran, I'm calling them grand waves. Grain?
Grain waves, I think.
Grain waves. One for your barker. And old Niggy just parked up by his old master there.
Looking pretty happy with himself.
We've got some venison saveloys on the go. In this big pot, they're about to bloody go, eh, Walt? Oh, fuck. Not helping the matter.
Fuck, the fire's blaring.
Yeah, fire's that's all we need now. And then we'll finish the night off with steam pudding.
Steam pudding, hard.
What do you reckon, Jacob?
Mate, it sounds like a fucking treat.
Yeah. Give you a bit of an update. It's cold. We've just come around and sit in the sun to warm up a little bit. Spotted quite a few deer actually. Old Benny spotted the first couple around the corner. There's two hinds and two stags. I think one was roughly, well, it could have been 6 points. The other one was he's a lot longer, but he didn't hang around, he dove off into the bush. Our wind's been shit as all morning, it's been up our ass. Hasn't been that ideal, but yeah, we've just come out to another spot and looking across onto this face, I managed to see a deer come over the skyline and another five followed, so we've got four deer, the bro spot over there, and six over here, so 10 deer, it's a good tally.
See some movement, eh?
Hard. Yeah, you enjoying your hunt, bro?
Loving it. Beautiful scenery.
Good to see some deer, eh?
Yeah, fuck yeah.
Especially your first time coming out.
Jeez. Buzzy, eh? So peaceful.
Two young stags, are they sparring?
So, we're taking a different way back. I've always wanted to check out this ridge up here in the bush. Looks quite open actually, quite good. So, I've been told there's a campsite up the top. I've never been there, so be good to go check it out, or hopefully I can find it. Might be worth coming back for a couple nights. It's a mean spot in here. Give you a look at this. Here comes the boys.
Boys pressure, mate.
Giving Jacob a good taste of the Ruahines. Get him into a bit of bush bashing.
Fucking love it.
Character building, mate.
Fuck yeah. Cars are filming it.
Yeah. Oh shit, here they come. Oh no, they've held up. Anyway, the old shingle slips, eh? Yeah. 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 Was it about 11 o'clock you showed up?
I think it was like 11:30.
Yeah.
Nah, 11-ish.
Yeah. And there's old Two. Two's growing up. I don't even know if we've got any footage of Two in one of the videos.
First hunt. Pretty stoked with her.
Yeah. Just
sort of winding up a bit and getting onto some scent. She's never smelt or even seen a deer before, but best way to learn how to hunt is on the hill.
Yeah. Look at her eyes. She's got a blue eye and a brown eye. It's pretty cool. Yeah, boys are just packing up in here. We'll be making our way out. I've got to go bloody help the old man out on the farm. Go do some feeding out for a few hours. Bro, what were you going to go do?
I've got some work to do. Weekly reports.
Yep.
That weekly report.
Yep. Hey. I'm the durries, boy. I'm the durries. You're back on the durries. Yeah. Haven't you got like a 100-mile race coming up?
Yeah.
Yeah. Oh, looking steezy, mate.
Got the shades on the side, mate. Yeah. Ready for the hike out?
Yep. Cheer the boys! Cheer, mothers! Back out on the fence line and we're battening today. I've borrowed an air compressor from old Alistair. So shot up to Waipak this morning and grabbed that. And yeah, me and Benny just probably smashed out just over 100 metres. So about of a quarter of the way through. I'm just doing a bit of an update in here because it's pretty windy outside. If I start trying to talk to you guys out there, you probably won't be able to hear me because it'd be like sound like shit. There it is. The abandon's on. Yep, so we've got old Bose's four-wheeler there and the old trailer. That wind's gonna be absolutely horrible to try to listen to me talk. Oh, so we got the this gauging rod here. So as I showed you the other day, we're using it for our post spacings. It's exactly 4 meters. So now we're using it for our battening spacings as well. So that tape is increments of 800, 1600. Now the dart mass are coming in 24, Ben, would it? 2400, 3200, 4 meters. So yeah, shit, all our buddy battens are blowing down. She's that windy today, eh, nearby?
My hard work, bro, has been ruined.
Yeah. Oh well.
But pretty much how Philip left it, really.
Hard. So yeah, as you see, that's our line. Be pumping. I'll set the old camera up, run a bit of a time lapse. Niggs, what you up to? Oh, you want bloody belly rubs? Fucking good life, eh? Living the good life. We'll be right back.
Best thing about this rod compared to the bungees is you don't have to walk back to get your bungee. Unhook it and then walk 8 meters, hook it onto there, hook it back up to here. With the rod you can just slide it across. You don't have to walk that extra fucking few steps, eh, babe?
Yeah, bro.
Make sure someone's account, make sure everything's all square and to height. And then yeah, we're away. Gotta remember to fucking reload, boys.